Hello friends, myself Ravi and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we will take a look on the basic tags that are used to write the HTML document. So let's drive to the tutorial. Let's take a look on the basic tags that is used in HTML. So before that, let me tell you one thing. So whatever starts with this opening tag and close with this closing tag, and the content, so these all thing, opening tag, content and the closing tag, this is called element. Okay, and these with less than and greater than sign, and inside that this title, this is called tags, if you remember from the previous video. Okay, now let's see some basic tags that are used. First of all is the meta tags. So give the name as meta, and to write the meta tag you don't need to write the closing tag. So some of the tags you won't need to write the closing tags. Okay, so this is meta tag. Now we will assign something to this meta tag. So we will assign what kind of character set that we are going to use in this HTML document. For that we will write char set equals to, in double quotes, UTF-8. So this is the character set that we generally uses to write the HTML doc. Now if you see inside this meta tag, we have written this char set, right? So this char set is called the property that is binded to this tag. Okay, so in this way you can bind any property to the tag. So suppose we have also one another different meta tag, so let's write that meta. Okay, and then we will write some properties into this meta tag. So how we write the property? We write the name of property here equals to, in double quotes we write the value of that property. Okay, so let's assign one property here. The name of that property is name. Okay, name equals to double quotes, so the property name is name, and you can write the value of this property, which is, let's say, description. Okay, we will also define one another property similarly, the name of property and then the value of property. So let's say the property name is content equals to double quotes. Inside that we will write, suppose this is right click. So this is the meta tag that we use inside this header tag. Okay, now other than these, let's take a look on the basic tags that we use. Let's remove this. So we will start with the heading tag. So basically heading tag is used to wrap up the words. So suppose we had this welcome to right click, right? Now if I want to show this word into different sizes, how we can show it? Let's see that. We can show it by using the header tags. Header tag is written as less than, then h for header, and we name it from 1 to 6 according to the different text sizes. So let's start with h1, and now we will make this closing tag. You can write anything inside this h1 tag. So let's write welcome to right click. Okay, now if I refresh the browser, you can see this text is shown like this. Similarly, if I write let's copy this text. Let's write h and then 2 tag, so header 2, and inside that let's put the similar text. If you refresh the browser, let's remove this. If you refresh the browser, you can see the h2 tag is shown here, but the font size has shrinked, right? Now let's also write h3 tag similarly, also then h4 tag, okay, then write h5 tag, again give h6. So header tag is written from h1 to h6, right? You cannot write h7, so it will be from h1 to h6. Okay, now if I refresh the browser, you can see from h1 to h6, as we go down, the font has shrank, right? So it is getting smaller and smaller. So this is how you can implement the h1 tag. Now let's remove all this. Okay, let one h2 tag remain here. Okay, now in order to wrap block of text, we can use the paragraph tag. So for paragraph tab, let's write it less than then p and greater than symbol. So the opening tag and closing tag, inside this you can write anything that is in text. Suppose we write this is awesome website. Okay, if I refresh the page, you can see this text is in the paragraph form. Okay, so if I write something bigger text, if you see that doesn't come in a screen, this screen size. Okay, I've just pasted this 4 times. Now let's see, if I refresh it, you can see, right, it's automatically adjusted into a paragraph here, whatever you write. So this is how this p tag works. Okay, now let's remove all this. Okay, inside p tag you can also use something like, let's suppose we want to highlight one of the text here, right, this website. So we can use bold tag. So bold tag is opening b, okay, the closing b, and then let's put this website thing inside it. Okay, now if I refresh this, you can see this is the paragraph, and inside that this website is bold. Okay, we can similarly make this website italic also. We can use I tag, I opening and then closing I tag. Okay, and if I refresh this, you can see this website is italic. We can use both italic and bold tag together also. Now let's add b tag inside this, put this I tag. Okay, so if you see, we have this bolder closing and opening tag, we have this I opening and closing tag, inside this we have put this website. Now the paragraph and then this website will be bolder and italic both. Now let's refresh it, you can see this website is italic and bolder, right? So you can apply both on the text also. Now you can see one thing, if we want to add some spaces or break into our website. How we can do that? So you may think, if I gave some enter, okay, we have given this much space, so in the website this space will be shown, right? Let me refresh it. So you can see, right, there is no space, nothing, a three new line inserted between these two. So HTML doesn't work like this. Okay, and one more thing, if you see the order in which you give the tags, the same order is maintained here on the browser. So if I put this above, okay, and refresh it, you can see the order has changed, right? So this thing also you need to keep in mind. Now we can also use something to break the content. So suppose we have written these things, right, and now I am writing one more p tag, okay, and we will write this is paragraph. Okay, now what we want, we want these two texts should be get separated with this text. Okay, so for that we can use something called break tag. So break tag is single tag. Why it is single tag? We don't have opening and closing something like that. It has this br and then slash, and this is called this single tag. Okay, now if I put this anywhere, it will create a break between the component. So it will create a break between the contents. So if I refresh the browser, you can see some space has been added to this content, right? So it's gets separated. Now we can also use one tag that is called horizontal line. So in order to separate these two content, we can also draw one horizontal line and it will get separated, right? So for that we can add similar single tag HR tag. Okay, so this is the horizontal line. Now if I refresh it, you can see one horizontal line added here, right? So this will add the break into the contents. So you can use it to separate the contents. Now the next tag, that is, now let's add one more paragraph. Okay, this is awesome website used for web development. Okay, now we want that this is up to this, the text should be little bit bigger in size, and after this, suppose this website used to, this text should be smaller in size. For that we can use big and small tags. So let's add that big opening tag. Okay, and then let's copy this. Now if I refresh this page, you can see this is in the bigger size, right? And let's put from here small. Okay, and let's put, suppose, this awesome website thing into this small tag. Okay, now if I refresh the page, you can see this awesome website is in a smaller text, right? So this is one of the basic tags that you can use to manipulate the text content of your HTML document. Okay. Now we have something called subscript and superscript in order to work with some mathematical texts. So how that looks like, let's suppose we have one p tag and we write h2o, right? H2O. And if I refresh it, you can see this h2o is written like this, but we want this h and this 2 is little bit below the h, right? So for that we can use subscript. Okay, so for subscript you can write opening tag sub, then make the closing tag and put this h2o, control x. Now let's put h here and 2, which will be little bit below the h, put it here, and o here. Now let's refresh the browser. You can see this is h2o, so h2o looks like as it should, right? We also have some mathematical terms. Suppose this p tag, okay, and we have 105. We want to show 10^5, okay? So if I refresh it, you see it's 105, right? So it's not 10^5. So in order to do that, we can add one superscript. For that, opening sup, closing, and then let's cut this 5, put it under the superscript tag. Okay. So if you see here, we have put 10 and then this 5 is under the superscript tag. If I refresh it, you can see now it's 10^5, right? So these are the basic tags that are used in HTML. So HTML, it is, these basic tags are used to manipulate the different texts that we want in our website. So we can manipulate the text sizes, styles, the way it is rendering on the UI. Okay, so these are the basic tags that we can use in HTML. So that's it for this video. If you have any doubt regarding anything, if you have any doubts regarding this tutorial, please comment it below. I will definitely try to answer it. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe our channel to get more updates. Thanks and have a nice day.